Everyone, it's me NoishiXzen and you are watching NoishiXzen. So in this video we're going to make Admob or AdSense implementations in our Sketchware professional applications. So let's start it. You can see I already opened one project. It has two buttons and there is one banner and interstitial ad. So it's a normal banner and it's a medium banner. And these are two different type of buttons. You can see one for loading interstitial, another for remote ads. And here's one simple linear tree. And if I move to component section, you can see there is two different type of components. I mean the same component with different names. You can find this component when you click on this plus one and you can choose this interstitial ad over there. And name it like whatever you want, then you good to go and open this on create activity. You will definitely find this block add view on load. Go to view section, view area of your logic thing or logic sector, and you will get this Google on add view to load your current banner. After that, go to view area, and here you need to place after this ad loaded, create and load your interstitial and banner ads. Definitely, they're obviously same, but for your app, it's kind of different. So, go to component section, and you will find different type of components like on ad loaded, on ad failed to load. On ad loaded for your ads and fail to load for your ads. So just set up your ad loaded. When ad is loaded, you need to place on interstitial ad also show. You can find this block also in component section. You can find it under Admob area. And then there is no other codes required. So before you place or run this application, make sure you are set up or good to go with the Admob settings. First, visit Admob site. I already opened Google Admob and sign up with my default account. You can see it's kind of some missing message like we have missing payment information. So I think it's kind of basic or trick you can do by yourself. Just press on add payment info and place your payment for receiving your payment. Now you can see there is add your performance view report, but we don't have to do anything. Press on this three dot, go to apps and press on add app. Make sure you are choosing your current platform. You are going to go with Android, and then if your application is already published on Play Store or App Store or no. So I didn't, so it's no. Okay, continue. Now place a name, example. For giving some example, then add your application. Now make sure there is a two type of things, like first one, advertiser know which is ad or source or authorized cell. Like this ad text means like you can implement this ad text. We are going to have this look in another tutorial or second part of the tutorial. And we only do work on this ad units right now. So you can also implement app ad text for getting from other sources like any other Google or any kind of YouTube sources for showing your ads, your contents. Now create an ad unit. Now you can choose the various type of ads. Definitely we are making interstitial and reward ads. So we're going to create interstitial and reward ads. So choose interstitial, select it and name it like interstitial ad. And you can also work on this advanced settings like your ad reach and frequency capping also. You can see there are two major like instruction, like one for SDK and another for implementing guide, the code. both are really important. Make sure you have already copy and paste in your site and place it done, and press on this add another unit and select reward application. Name it like reward type and create add unit. It's kind of same like reward and done. Now you can see we have interstitial and reward with our custom ID, and these two different IDs are required for running your ads in your application. But before we jump up to this our setting in our Admob setting in our Sketchware project, I want to let you know that after you have creating this system like these ads or ad units, it takes around 2 to 3 days for activating your application, so you cannot or you are unable to use instantly. So Google will review your application first, then it will be active. So you can see there are meditation groups and it say this is zero active, so these apps are not active yet. So I'll tip copy and paste some example ad units. So let's jump up to the our settings on Sketchware. Now press on this and go to library section. In this Admob section, you already see I already added two different app IDs because these two IDs are already activated. Click on this settings and press on add manual. Give your unit name interstitial and place add unit ID. Just copy it from here. You can see the small copy icon for interstitial. Place it over there and add. You can see interstitial added, and do same thing for reward ad. You can see interstitial and reward added. Now press next, and for this banner you can add this reward ad, and for interstitial you can add interstitial and place next. Make sure you have choose the correct your device ID. So some of these issues are already given down when you didn't or forget to choose your test device, and click on next and you can save it. But I'm not going to save it because these ads are not activated yet. So let's move back to my default settings, and if I didn't choose or if I do not want to choose this device, so make sure I'm deleting this for giving you some ideas what it happens. So before you test this thing, like I want to show you how we create this reward ads, because this is completely different. It's not in our Sketchware. So first we made reward ads as a new interstitial ad. So we are defining reward ad is a kind of interstitial ad that contains our application get ID, and then we have placed this ad listener, important thing, ad listener. Then we have given reward ads as a unit ID. This unit ID is important, like you have already given one ID. So just simply copy paste over there in this section, you'll have it. Then also change the device ID from here. So we don't have any test device right now, you can see. Now let's run this application, let's see what happened. Now our application is installing, you can see. Now open it. Now press interstitial ad. Now you can see ads failed. Press on reward ads error. It means it's lack of your ad device or your test device. you can see that this device is empty. Go to settings, next, next, and add this device. You can see automatically generated. Next and save. Now your application will work. Definitely run it. Let's run and install this application for last time. Open it. Load your interstitial ads, so you can see. But you will definitely find this ads are test ad. So you guys already asked me. So if you're a new user, you can subscribe my channel. Find my channel over there. You can see we are already 300 subscribers. Please subscribe my channel and support me for new projects also. And you'll definitely find all Sketchware projects and other technical guides for yourself and for your friends, whatever. You can share my channel with your friends also. So let's jump to the tutorial again. So where we are. So you guys already asked me how we can make it like real ads. For this, we have to sign in. We need to sign in this application in perfect way. So how we can do that? Go to search and for APK editor. You can see his APK editor pro. So I'm giving you this application from my description. You will find my blog from this description. Go there, you can find this application pro and also this project free. You can download it. But before that, please subscribe my channel, it will help me. And if you have any problem, you can comment down below. But before you choose your application, go to settings. And here under this APK building, make sure you sign an APK with key created by APK data. And then output name will be Xzen, means Xzen signed APK. But I recommend you go with package name, because if you want to submit your application in Play Store, they will they want this package name first. Now choose your application from APK. Already have Admob, you can see. Now choose full edit, decode all files, you can see. Now press on build. Make sure to sign the APK checked already. Now press OK. And it's done, you can see. Now remove your current Admob ads application. It's uninstalled. For Android 11 users, you cannot install directly from APK editor like me. For that, you need to visit file manager where you have this thing. Go to APK editor folder and then install this application. Now open this application. You can see it's a real ad, not a test ad. Now for your ads.
जो भी इस गाड़ी में इंटरेस्टेड है लाइन लगाएं।
So you can see it's completely real ads, not a fake one. You can close this video. So it's completely done. I guess it will definitely help you out. You'll definitely find one link or blogspot link in my video's description, and there you can find this project as an example and also APK editor pro. So guys, if you like this video, please subscribe and help other developers too, because already there are many more developers or beginners already asking me about this kind of real ads and featuring ads. And of course, in the second video, second part, we will be more we'll be initiating our ideas more deeply. For that, please subscribe and stay tuned for upcoming videos. Thank you guys, thank you for watching and stay tuned.